Chris Wood. I'm a co-owner of Woody's Ocean Grill. I grew up across the bridge in Rumson. I spent every waking moment in the summer in Seabright. Love the water, love this town. And you know, it's I'm magnetized towards Seabright, as probably most people are from the area. It's a wonderful place to be.
My name is Frank Bain. I'm the owner of Bain's Hardware. My son was a surfer, and I would drive him down to Seabright all the time. And that's, you know, and then I saw an ad in the paper. We answered an ad. The rest is history.
It's an amazing town, Seabright.
I always say that to people. They're like, you're such a Seabrighter. And I said, I am. Where else can you live where you see the sunrise and the sunset?
Yes.
We have lived in Seabright 17 years.
People come here because it's open. We don't have any kind of restrictions. We're a beach club, yet we're a bar more than a beach club. Comradeship that people have experienced here. We've probably had literally thousands of people meet their future spouses here.
We opened in Seabright in 1994. Seabright is an eclectic little town. Everyone in the town has been helpful to us since the first day we're here, and they continue to be.
I was born and raised here, yeah. My parents bought this house back in the early 1950s. My grandfather owned this property, but the thing that's stayed consistent with Seabright that I find over the years is, you know, it's got a real eclectic culture. It's, you know, the location is wonderful, but it's the people here that make it special.
Today is Sunday, October 28, 2012. I am back in Seabright, where an incoming storm is becoming increasingly evident every hour. The ocean is churning, the wind is picking up, and the temperature has dropped. Today is the last day to prepare for Hurricane Sandy.
This morning I formally declared a state of emergency in anticipation of Hurricane Sandy, which is expected to be a severe and a potentially devastating storm that will hit New Jersey.
Friday night, this one is real. We're watching the opening moments of what could be an enormous natural disaster.
Hurricane Sandy threatening a massive stretch
of the perfect storm type.
Because the Frankenstorm is getting
one of the largest we've ever seen in the Atlantic Basin.
A very rare meteorological situation. So this could be historic, folks.
Broken windows and empty hallways, a pale dead moon in a sky streaked with gray. Human kindness is overflowing, and I think it's gonna rain today.
It was hard, obviously, the cleanup, number one. Right, but then again, you couldn't get into town. The town was under, you know, 6 to 10 feet of sand. There were gas leaks all over town. It was a very dangerous situation.
4 feet of our inventory
piles.
Just piled high with silt, and we had to shovel a path to get through
your house. And you just what do you
cry? We cried when we walked through. We were, I think it really didn't register. It's kind of like he said, it was like a out of body experience. Cause you're like, how could this possibly have happened?
And we've been through, you know, tons of storms. So we stayed and when the water came in, somehow some of our koi got in through the pet port and they were swimming in our house. Yeah, this is where we celebrated every Thanksgiving and every Christmas for the past half a century, and it's a little strange to think, well, we'll never have another holiday here. Sorry. I promised myself I wasn't gonna cry.
Have you ever seen a storm like this then in your history?
I mean, never, never.
Because you've spent some storms here. There's been floods and stuff.
Oh yeah, I remember the 92 storm. I was closed for 5 days and reopened, no problem. This was, I just couldn't think about coming back. It was just so over the top.
I didn't realize that Donovan's was gonna be hit by a giant storm as large as this one was. I mean, 92 was large. This one made that look very small.
actually, you know, during that idle time that I had because I couldn't be here, I thought, what could I do to help the town? Where are the needs going to be? And that's when we started this whole relief effort with the food.
Hey, you're doing a great job. We appreciate everything you're doing for this town.
I appreciate it. Thank you very much.
We need people like you.
Chris Wood may not be the mayor of Seabright, New Jersey, but he is spearheading the relief efforts here. And the actual mayor, Dina Long, couldn't be happier.
Well, I'm glad to see you smiling.
In times of crisis, people's true colors really come through. And boy, Chris Wood's are bright colors.
We've been doing about 150 breakfasts, somewhere around 2,000 lunches.
Rather than have the workers and the state troopers and the electricians go over to Rumson or Long Branch and waste an hour and a half of their day trying to get lunch, come here, get something to eat, increases productivity, get back to work, let's get this town built.
And so these are donation?
Donations.
Everything's been donation.
My phone rings nonstop. It's like, hi, I'm Mary from Pepsi. I heard you guys need soda. I'm like, we can use some. She goes, well, I've got 10 pallets. Yep. What do you say now? So there's a tractor trailer here, unloading pallets of Coke, Pepsi, Gatorade, and what have you. It's crazy.
And the next thing I know, I'm getting a phone call at 2:30 in the morning from some general in the Army National Guard. And he's like, who are you anyway? I said, I'm just a common citizen who owns a restaurant. And he goes, well, I've got direct orders to talk to you and fill whatever requirements you need. You know, it turned into this incredible blueprint for what to do, I think, during a disaster.
An unwavering sense of hope among the people of Seabright.
We need to get home.
Despite the destruction that surrounds this year's holiday tree, it's become a reflection of the town's determination to rebuild. On Wednesday, John Murata hung a simple ornament with a powerful message.
It inspired me to push forward and rebuild and bring this community back to where it was and even better.
Just a few days after Hurricane Sandy, Mayor Dina Long addressed the community for the very first time. Moments before the meeting, she found a piece of a sign in the wreckage. Two letters, D-O.
It says do, because do is what we're gonna do, and we're gonna rebuild our town.
Since then, the slogan has helped motivate the town through its recovery, but now it's getting an extra boost from a popular band.
Hopefully we can bring some attention and a little bit of money to you guys to help you rebuild.
There's finally cause for celebration in Seabright. On Wednesday, Bain's Hardware Store became the first business in town to open its doors in the wake of Sandy.
They want me hugging the customers.
Right, really.
It's okay, we can hug.
Enjoy that, huh? Congratulations.
Thank you
very
much.
So happy for you.
We did it. You know, we made it. I don't like to live in the past. You know, I'm a very, very blessed person.
You know, everybody talks about coming back. This is just obviously a huge sign that it's a reality.
As you can see, there's a ton of energy in this town. We're coming back. We're going to come back hard.
I'm Brian Kirk, and what is Seabright doing? They're rising!
Seabright rising!
Seabright rising!
I am Kim Chaos, and Seabright is rising!
Seabright rising!
Seabright is rising!
Seabright rising!
Hi, I'm Meg Fisher and this is Savannah. We live on Surf Street and Seabright's rising!
Seabright rising. Okay, we're getting it done. D.O. from Dunham's. Seabright rising.
Seabright rising!
Seabright rising!
Seabright rising!
Seabright rising!
Seabright
rising!
Seabright rising! Seabright rising!